left his folks in Albany, those rebels weren't for him. Was loyal to the crown, by George, he wasn't giving in. And he could slip through enemy lines, the likes you'll never know. And would return both with fresh troops and prisoners in tow. So Captain Johnny Waltermeyer fought against those bloody Yanks. King George III gave him some land, his way of saying thanks. Ceded him 1,000 acres to his heirs forevermore. That the leadership of men like him's what got us through the war. John settled in Ontario and built himself a mill. He founded Meyer's Creek, now known as present-day Belleville. Made lumber, bricks, and whiskey, traded furs and built an inn. And a ship sailed to St. Lawrence, took his goods down to Kingston. This man was called a loyalist, and he would sure be mighty pissed if he knew what they were doing to this land we love. Says from old England's king, but our government don't care a thing, even though it's by the grace of God above. Cause those times are gone, progress has come, it's not like days of yore. Perpetuity doesn't last long anymore. Now Frank has owned this land since 1974. Worked with his dad since he was old enough to help with chores. Even turning 85, he still would work the land. Fifth generation in his name, passed on from hand to hand. Son John would be the sixth one with the same name as before. 200 years of heritage, you don't see that much no more. So when you read the old king's deed, make sure you check the date. The 22nd day of May in 1798. Living thing, it takes hard work to keep alive. They've made him sell his crops and heard no way he can survive. Baffled by the lawyers, he signed off under duress. Politicians called it progress while the Meyers felt distress. But no trespass sign upon the gate, the base wants to expropriate. They're showing up in armor with rifles in their hands. Take a man's life, sweat and toil, this isn't hostile foreign soil, this here is truly loyalist's own land. Now we've learned invasions aren't just on a distant shore, perpetuity don't last so long no more. Trenton brought in big machinery to tear apart his life, but then folks started showing up to help Frank and his wife. How my heart swells with pride in this our great country, joining neighbors, strangers, and new friends to stand on guard for thee. I stopped in on Frank and Marjorie the other day, was headed home for the holidays, and it was on my way. They shared their kitchen table, welcomed me with open arms, like 1,000 kitchen tables on 1,000 other farms. And dreams how tomorrow's a new day. Gave me some fresh apples as they sent me on my way. And when he wished me all the best, I realized you've got a bet. He's still Waltermeyer and he ain't done fighting yet. This man is called a loyalist and he is getting mighty pissed. So just back off his land and leave him well enough alone. Seems Green's own laws only apply if there is not some other guy who wants to tear apart your happy home. The time has come, the talking's done, the gloves are off, it's war. Perpetuity means forever, just like it did before.